السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. This is Hani Ismail from Planning Engineer website. In this lesson, we are going to discuss the resource loading. Resource loading, very similar to the cost loading. Now you might ask yourself, Hani, why I need resource loading? I don't need it. There is a main golden rule in project management. You cannot manage what you cannot measure. If you don't know how many resources you need in your project and when, how you can be sure that your project will be completed on time? You might hire more resources or less resources, and both cases is not correct. So resource loading sheet is very important document. Our target in the cost loading phase was to calculate the cost of each activity. Our target now in the resource loading phase is to calculate the needed hours of resources to finish the activity. Knowing the activity hours help us allocate needed resources and equipment and estimate the duration. You might ask yourself why the duration is linked to the resources. Sometimes when the activity is a resource-driven activity. Let's say you are erecting the facade using two equipments. This equipment can produce certain productivity per day. So the duration of your activity will definitely be based on the available resources. Also, resource loading is useful to help us tracking the productivity in your site. Are you paying more money and getting less work, or are you okay? All of these things, which is part of the planning and cost control, can be only monitored if you have a proper resource loading sheets. If the activity took hour more than the planned hour, that means the actual productivity is less than the planned productivity. Let's talk about productivity. What I mean by productivity? The amount of work someone can produce in certain time. Simple, very simple. Please don't be confused, because I received too many questions about productivity, whether it is unit per hour or hour per unit. Once you understand the productivity concept, you don't need to be confused. From activity hours, we can calculate how much labor we need per day to finish the activity in a certain duration. I'll tell you in a minute. There is a triangle: the duration, activity hours, and labor number. Once you change any of these criteria, the other two will be changed. If the activity needs 160 hours, we are working 8 hours per day. The number of labor man days needed. So if an activity needs 160 hours, we are working 8 hours per day. So the number of labors or man days required is 20. So we need 20 man days. Now, we have one of two scenarios. Let's talk about them. If we have to finish the activity in 5 days, it means what? It means that we need to divide the 20 man days by 5 days of the duration, so we need 4 workers per day. If we need to finish the activity in 2 days, we will divide the 20 man days by the 2 days we have. It means we need 10 workers per day. So this is the benefit of calculating the resources. Let's take another example. If an activity required 160 hours and we are working 8 hours per day, it means we need 20 working days. If we have only 4 workers, that means this is a resource-driven activity. It means that we will divide this 20 man days by the 4 workers we have. It means we can finish this activity in 5 days. But if we have only 1 worker, it means that we need 20 working days to finish this activity. Let's talk about another example about equipment. If we have an excavation activity, need 300 hours. We are working 10 now, not 8, 10 hours per day. It means the number of equipment days needed is 30. If we have only 1 excavator, by logic, we need 30 days. If we have 3 excavators, we can finish this job in 10 days. We understood the importance of calculating activity hours to calculate and allocate the needed labor and equipment per day or per month and per project. But how to calculate the activity hours? What parameters do you think can affect the number of hours needed to finish the activity? Of course, the workload, the quantity of the activity, and the experience of the worker, how speed the labor are. So we are talking about quantity and productivity. These are the main things that requires to calculate the resources. Productivity rate is how much quantity is executed per time or unit. I can say I can execute 100 meter cube in 1 hour. This productivity is 100 meter cube per hour. You might have the productivity, but not per hour. You can say I can produce 100 meter cube in 2 hours. In that case, you need to change your productivity to unit per hour as well. So, okay, you say I can produce 50 meter cube per hour, which is 100 divided by 2. This is one form of showing the productivity, unit per hour. There is another way, is hour per unit. 100 meter cube in 1 hour equal to 0.01 hour per meter cube. So you can reserve the order of the productivity. Please don't be confused. It is very simple. You have to check only whether it is hour per unit or unit per hour. So to calculate activity hours, we need quantity and productivity rate. Let's say we have a quantity of 100 meter cube. The rate is 5 meter cube per hour. The total hours will be 100 divided by 5, which is equal to 20 hours. We can see that we have 5 meter cube. This is a productivity. Yeah? We can do it in 1 hour. Now we need to check if we have 100 meter cube, how many hours we want. Do you remember this cross multiplication? So the hour needed is 1 multiplied by 100 divided by 5. So this is our required. If you confused, you can use this method of calculating any productivity. As of this course, I'd like only to give you the overall picture. I'm expecting from you to be very good at these calculations. However, I'm telling you how things are done. Another example to calculate activity hours, we need quantity and productivity rate. Let's say the quantity is 200 meter cube. The rate is 0.15 hours per meter cube. So the total hours, we will multiply, because this is hour per unit, 200 by 0.15, so we need 30 hours. With cross multiplication, same, 1 meter cube, 0.15 hours. So 200 meter cube, how many hours? Make the cross multiplication, will give you the same amount of hours. I'm providing you with these slides as a PDF for your reference. You will find the link in the below this video. And if you are watching on YouTube, you will find the link in the description. So here, after estimating the productivity rate for each BOQ item, we calculate the hours needed for the BOQ item in order to calculate the total hours of the activity. So for example, here we have this activity. We have two items in the BOQ, but under one activity. So I'm going to calculate the hours for the activity, then add this to Primavera, which will give me the required hours per week, month. But this is the concept, and this is how it looks like when you are producing a professional resource loading sheet. You have here the activity ID, activity name, the BOQ item, unit, quantity, the floor percentage, and then you have here the hours. We have here the professions, like this hour is for carpenter, this is hour for labor, this hour for painter. You have different hour for different activities and different BOQ items. Once you upload all of these to Primavera, then you have the numbers or the man days required in this month and this month and this month, and you can then decide when you're going to hire your manpower. I hope you find this video useful to you. See you in the next one.